Good morning, dear children. Hope all of you are doing good. See here, I have some apples of different size. Can you see this? Now, I am going to arrange them in their increasing order of size. You know what is increasing order of size? That is smaller size to bigger size. Let us arrange these apples. For this, first I am keeping the smallest apple first. Then next, I am going to place the smaller one. Then next, the bigger one. And last, the biggest one. See here, we have arranged these apples in their increasing order or ascending order from smaller to bigger. Arranging things from smaller to bigger is known as ascending order or increasing order. Clear? See, next, here is some trees of different size. Now, we need to arrange these trees in their decreasing order. You know what is decreasing order? Decreasing order means bigger size to smaller size. So first we have to place the biggest tree. Clear? Then next, the bigger one. Then next, the smaller one. And last, the smallest one. See here, we have arranged these trees, their decreasing order of their size. Decreasing order of size. Decreasing order means bigger to smaller size, also known as descending order. Today we are going to learn ordering of numbers. Okay, already you have learned the ascending order of numbers. Now let us learn the ascending order of bigger numbers. Look at the board. We have some numbers here. We need to arrange them in their ascending order. Ascending order means increasing order. Ascending order. Numbers 317, 810, 390, 980. We have four numbers are here. We need to arrange them in their increasing order or ascending order. How we will arrange them in the ascending order? For that, first we have to write the smallest number. Look at the board. Can you tell which one is the smallest number here? The smallest number, how we will check? First we have to check the number from the leftmost digit. Ones, tens, hundreds. The leftmost side, here it is 3. Here 8, 3, 9. From these digits, which one is the smallest number? Yes, here we have 2 threes. 317, 390. Now, we have to check the next digit. That is, in tens place there is 1. Here is also 1. So what we will do? We have to check the ones place. In ones place here it is 7. Here 9. From this 7 and 9, 7 is the smaller number. Clear? So we can say 317 is the smallest number. So first we have to write 317 and then 390. Then next 8 and 9. We know 8 is smaller than 9. So we can write 810. Then next 918. We have arranged the numbers in their increasing order. 317, 390, 810, 980. This is the increasing order of these given numbers. or ascending order of numbers. Clear? So one more example.4,890, 8,490, 9,450, and 700, 7,201. We need to arrange these four digit numbers in their ascending order. The same method we have to check from the leftmost digit. Here it is 4, 8, 9, and 7. Which one will come first? Yes, we know here 4 is the smallest digit. 4, 8, 9, 7. From that, 4, 8, 7, 9. From these numbers, 4 is the smallest number. So we can say 4,890 is the smallest number. Clear? Then next, 8, 9, 7. Which one is the smallest number? 7,201. Then next, the number starts from 8,490. Then the last one is the biggest number, 9,450. Clear? This is the ascending order of numbers. Then next we are going to learn the descending order of number. What are descending order? Descending order means bigger to smaller. Descending order. Again here some numbers: 1,270, 9,870, 9,650, and 6,108. What we need to do? Descending order. That means decreasing order. Bigger size to smaller size. Which one is the biggest number here? Check from the leftmost side. 1, 9, 9, 6. We have two numbers starting in 9. 9, 8. Here 6. We know 8 is the greater number. So 9,817 is the biggest number. Clear? 9,817. First we have to write 9,817 greater than 9,615 greater than next 6,108 greater than 1,270. Did you understand? This is the descending order of these numbers. One more example. 2,080, 3,840, 8,212, 9,760. Can you say how we will arrange these numbers? Yes. The biggest number we need to write first. Check from the leftmost digit. 2, 3, 8, and 9. Which one is the bigger number? 9. So we have to write 9,760 first, which is greater than 8,212, greater than the next digit 3. 3 and 2 left. 3 is the bigger number. So we have to write 3,840 greater than 2,080. Clear? This is the descending order of numbers. So what we learned? The ascending order of numbers means smaller number to bigger number. Descending order of number means the bigger number to smaller number. Clear? Okay. Now we are going to learn the formation of four digit number. For that, four digits are given here. By using that four digit, we need to form the greatest four digit number and the smallest four digit number. Look at the board. It's given four digits here. 7, 1, 0, and 8. We have four digits. 7, 1, 0, 8. By using the given digits, we need to form a greatest number and a smallest four digit number. How we will form the greatest four digit number? Here, for getting the greatest four digit number, by using these digits, arrange the given digits in their descending order. Descending order means bigger to smaller. See here, greatest number. Greatest number. Arrange the given digits in their descending order. Descending order means the larger number we have to write first. Here, 8 is the larger number. Then next it will come 7 and then 1, last 0. When we are writing the digits, we should put the commas and separate the digits. But when we are writing the greatest number, don't put the commas. It is one number. 8710. Did you understand? Here, don't put the commas and only one time you should write the digit. Don't repeat the same digit. 8710. Clear? Then can you tell what is the smallest number we can form by using these digits? Smallest number. For getting the smallest number, arrange the given digits in their ascending order, smaller to bigger. But here, the smallest digit is 0. If we write the 0 first, what will come? 0, then next 1, then 7, and then 8. This is wrong, because here, how we will read this number? 1708. This is not 4 digit number, this is only 3 digit number. So, this is wrong. How we will write? First we have to write 1 and then we have to write 0, then 7 and next 8. Don't put commas, don't repeat digits. 1078. Clear? This is the smallest 4 digit number we can form by using these digits. Clear? One more example. See here, we have some digits 7, 5, 2 and 3. By using these digits, we need to write the greatest 4 digit number and smallest 4 digit number. Tell me, what is the greatest 4 digit number here? Greatest number. Greatest number is 7 is the largest digit here. So first you have to write 7, then 5, then 3, then last 2. This is the descending order of the digits. First we wrote the biggest number. Then next 5, 3, 2. 7532. This is the greatest number we can form by using the given digits. Clear? Then next we have to form the smallest number. The smallest number. Smallest number. Okay? For getting the smallest number, we have to arrange the digits in their ascending order. Ascending order means the smallest number first. 2, 3, 5, 7. Clear? Now, we are going to learn skip counting. Already you have learned skip counting in fives, tens, hundreds, etc. Do you remember that? How we will count in skipping by 5? 5, 10, 15, 20, etc. We have to add 5. Then next, skip counting in 10. 10, 20, 30, 40, etc. Now we are going to learn skip counting in hundreds and thousands. Look at the board. Skip counting in hundreds. Hundred, 200. How we will get? Add 100 to this first 100. 100 plus 100, 200. Again add 100 to this 200. We will get 300. Then next 400, etc. Here you see the hundreds place only changed. Ones place, tens place, hundreds place. Then the tens place and ones place remain unchanged. Hundreds place, here it is 1, here it is 2, 3 and 4. Ones place and tens place, there is 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0 itself. There is no change. For another example, 210. What will come the next number? To this 210, we need to add 100. 210 plus 100. What we will get? 310. 310. Then next 410. Then next 510. Here is also, look at this series. In ones place, tens place, hundreds place. Hundreds place, here it is 2, 3, 4, 5. But tens place and ones place remain unchanged. 10, 10, 10, 10. Only the hundreds place changed. 210, 310, 410, 510. Clear? One more example. 690, then next 790, 890, then 990. Did you understand this? Now we can see some larger numbers. See, skip counting in thousands. Thousand, then forgetting next number, add 1000 to this 1000. We will get 2000. Then next 3000, 4000 and so on. Did you understand how we got this numbers? Next 2310. Can you say which number will come next? 2310. Add 1000 to this number. If you add 1000, we will get 3310. The next number is 3310. Again add 1000 to this number, we will get 4310. The next 5310, etc. Clear? Okay. Next, 7980. Next, we will get 8980. Then next, 9980, etc. 7980, 8980, 9980, etc. This is the skip counting in thousands. Hope you understood this all. Now look at the board. Let us do some problems. Write the following numbers are even or odd. We have some numbers here. 1780, 2911, 3515 and 4876. We need to check these numbers are even or odd. First, we have the number 1780. How we will check? We have to check the ones place. Here, in ones place, there is 0. We know that 0 is an even number. 0 is even number. Here, 1780. In this number, in ones place, there is 0. We know 0 is an even number. So what we can say? 1780 is an even number. 1780 is an even number. Then next we have to check 2911. 2911. Which number in ones place? Here, in ones place there is 1. 1 is an odd number. So what we can say? 2911 is an odd number. Only we have to check the ones place. Here in 2911, in ones place there is 1. 1 is an odd number. So 2911 is an odd number. Clear? Then next, the third one is 3550. In ones place, there is 5. 5 is an odd number. So what we can say? 3550 is an odd number. 3550. In ones place, there is 5. So, 3550 is an odd number. Then the last one is 4876. Here, in ones place, there is 6. We know 6 is an even number. So, 4876 is an even number. Did you understand this all? Okay, that's all for today. Now you have to do the textbook exercise. Thank you.